go ahead and use Shots.so. This is an amazing mockup platform that you can use in mocking up designs for your dribble as a designer, as a UI UX designer. All right, and if you click on this, as you can see, it's really easy and it looks just similar to that of Framer. It's similar to Framer, and Framer is more like a website builder, or let me say website builder for UI UX designer, right? And I'm looking at Shots. You can see Shots.so is still in beta version. I think later on in the future they might actually introduce maybe having to log in into the account or having to introduce a paid version or a price, more of like a pricing to it, right? So on let's just run through the tutorial, right? So on the mockup section, you can actually select what kind of design are you trying to mock up. Are you trying to make use of a screenshot? Just make use of a screenshot, and this is the screenshot. Let's go ahead and upload an image real quick. I'll just drag the image into my design. I'll just go there to my design and drag it real in like so. All right, so now you can see this is it. This is what it looks like. So if you want to go ahead and create a mock-up design, you just have to click on this drop down and you select, you scroll down and you select the particular device you want to create a mock-up for. All right, but before that, let's quickly talk about this particular let's talk about other tools right here. So for the styles section, you can select any styles you want. You can select default, stack, retro, border, glass lights, and so many more. You can also come and play around with the border and you change the border if you want. If you don't want any border, you just have to take it down to the zero, and if you want border, you just have to increase it a little bit. There is no pixel size or pixel size for the particular border, right? Everything is just about dragging and selecting the right, and more of like using your height to try and gauge every single information on the screen. And you can also select it right here by selecting shape, sharp, curved, and round. If you scroll down, you can also reduce the shadow. If you want add shadow, you can do that. If you want a soft shadow, you can do that. If you want non-shadow, if you want any shadow at all, you can remove that. And if you want just little shadow, you can add that. And you can also play around with the scaling. You can scale it up to the fullest, you can scale it down to the lowest, and you can also scale it out a little bit. You're right, you can play around with it. And right here, it has to do with positioning. How do you want to position this? See, it's more like absolute. How do you want to position the design in this particular frame? All right, let's say in this particular frame, so you can position it at the end of the design. You can position it as anywhere you want. Just have to select on the particular box you want. All right, so if you scroll down, you notice there is this X and Y axis. You can actually go ahead and play around with the X and Y. X has to do with left to right, Y minus Y, or plus Y has to do with top and bottom, right? So you can adjust this. You can say you can adjust this. You can adjust this anyhow you want. All right, you can adjust that, and you can also go ahead and select mockup styles right here on the right hand panel. Select that. You can select that. Just select anyone. You can also scroll on it. It might not look scrollable, but you can actually scroll on it. And you can see just like so. And if you want to go, if you don't like this background color, you can always change that by coming to the frame section, and from this frame section you'll be able to select color. Currently you can also paste your color. You can paste your color, your code, compare your X code, your specific here, and you can also make a transparent background if you want. You can also make use of an image background. If you have an image, you can also import that into the design, and you can make use of a solid color. You can see we have different solid colors. You can just select them depending on the one you want. You can select them, and we also have gradients. You can make use of any gradients you like right here. And you have desktop, we have vintage style, vintage gradients, and lots more. All right, so if you actually enjoyed this video, you can actually go ahead and subscribe to the channel for more tutorials on UI UX. And you can also get and download this right here. Once you download this, then you've successfully you can go ahead and upload this design to your Dribbble account or Behance. So that is, guys, on how to go ahead and navigate through Shots.so in case you're having difficulty navigating through it. That is, guys, for this video. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.